Hey guys, Samore here bringing you some more 7 Days to Die. And like I had previously mentioned in the other episode, I managed to not record my voice track as I was playing the game. So we're going to get right to it. Let's see. I am placing some forges, and this is basically because I ran out of iron and needed to create some more rebar frames. This tower is going to take quite a bit. And of course I left the other iron mold and totally did not do that one correctly. I left the other iron mold at the forward operating base, which is more of like a forward operating shanty at the moment, I think. It's not, not very well secured, not like I'd like to. Now, if I was smart right here, what I would do is I would make like 3 forges, but hindsight, 2020. So I'm going to get that going. And I remember being at the time a little worried about calling a horde down by raising the heat map of the area. I guess we'll just have to wait and see. From here, my inventory is looking a little full, and so I'm just kind of going over what I could or could not leave as I continue to go build. At least I think that's what I'm doing. What am I doing?
Dying.
I am not dying, and they can't hear you unless you're over here to make fun of me over here. Oh, see, I was making gravel so I can make more cement. That, of course, ladies and gentlemen, my super awesome wife. I almost feel like at this point she needs no introduction. You guys seem to have loved the video between the two of us much more than you like the videos of me by myself. Plot twist. Remember, the space bar is not necessary for climbing ladders. It turns out you will just jump backwards off the ladder and plummet to your death, which is why that hay bale is down there. So you go all the way up, close the hatch. Don't push spacebar like I did there. Close the hatch and just keep walking forward. No jumping necessary. And I didn't clip the spike. All right. So if you haven't watched the video before this one, basically we picked out a location and we started building the footprint. There's me being super scared of calling in a horde from all the forging that's going on. Queued up quite a bit. But what's nice is this isn't so far away that we lose the forges, and the cement here continues to cure. That was weird, but all right. And so right now I'm just trying to evaluate how I want to place these with regard to the ground not being entirely level. These eventually on this quadrant-ish shape of the tower are going to go away eventually anyway, so I throw them down just so we have something to help protect us here come day 14. We've got quite a bit to do yet. Come day 14, we need to get the lip built on this thing. We need to get the spikes laid down. We got to upgrade said spikes. We probably got to go a layer or two higher with the cement walls or the reinforced concrete walls. So we got a bit to do yet. We have quite a bit to do yet. And of course, wood, as always, wood. Always so strapped. So it looks like I'm going to upgrade what we got down right now. Continue to go through all the iron. I can't recall if I had enough to do this whole thing or if I had to stop and get some more. It's actually kind of loud, almost as loud as the auger. Just gonna go collect some more wood. My wife laughed. Oh my god. It's all right. Wood. Phrasing. So, are you guys looking at Joel's Tumblr, his blog? He's got some very good-looking art of the new skies in Alpha 12. They look ridiculously good. I feel like they look better than most other skies I have seen. They almost look as good as the skies in Skyrim. It's a little ridiculous how good they look, especially for a game that's an alpha, done by a small group of guys. I've also heard some rumblings that the single player, the quote unquote single player mode of the game, being able to set your game type as SP when you roll the world, is going away, and that they're going to have, you won't be able to have that option anymore. You'll just be creating a multiplayer game that you lock people out from getting into. Kind of like how Creativerse does it, kind of like how Life is Futile does it. So, yeah, and we'll see if that comes to fruition or not. I don't know if it's official or not, but there you go. Just something I've heard. So again, still evermore wood. What's good though is with this build, once I get the spikes down, it shouldn't be too much more wood after that. Yes, sweetheart, wood. Boom, headshot. I wonder, it would be nice if you could get extra experience for headshots. Like, not much, like, plus 10% or something. I don't think that's too much. Or maybe plus, 10% experience if you kill at night while they're running, but maybe that would be too overpowered because people would just sit on top of a rampart. Kind of like what I'm hoping to do here come, day 13 and 14. Yeah, so maybe that one's not such a good idea. And as always, while doing all knocking the trees down and foraging and building and making a bunch of noise, I get super concerned about having a horde surprise me. Because I mean, they'll be on you, before you really even get a chance to notice. If you aren't constantly checking your flank, checking behind you, they'll be on you. So, just something that I know as I'm playing, I'm always kind of listening and watching for. In fact, I'm like listening as I'm watching me play right now, wondering if I'm going to spot a horde, knowing full well what happens. Like, I'm still just in the habit. Okay, nothing. Let's get back to work. Come on, let's go. Oh, there it is. Way out there. Shot and a miss. Oof, strike two. Finally. Worst shot ever. Though I feel like the crossbow, if they fix the crossbow now, because how you wind up putting the cursor up and to the left of what you want to hit in the head. If they fixed it now, I wouldn't know what to do. I would just miss all the time. At this point, just don't mess with it. Fun pimps, you hear me? Just don't mess with it. More log spikes. I think we're gonna do just the single layer, and from there, I think we're gonna continue to build up. So let's finish up the log spikes here. And apparently, I am like too drunk to type, just the worst, apparently. And I throw those on the ground because inventory management is for suckers, apparently. Just kidding. I actually love doing inventory management. It's a little sick. Yes, very sick. I got super awesome wife in the background just making fun of me as I make this stuff. But yeah, you guys seem to really like the video of her and I playing. I mean, it's gotten more comments, likes, and views in a shorter amount of time than any other video I've done. I was very impressed, and everybody has been super encouraging. So thank you very much for that, guys. And again, another useful thing for chopping down all these trees, line of sight. With the trees being so pretty now, they obscure quite a bit. And so just being able to see and have that line of sight is really important. I wonder if Alpha 12, or in Alpha 12, they will wind up pushing back the view distance. I wonder what their plan is for that. And I hate to waste the plant, but we have work to do, and we don't actually have much time to do it in. So. That was just me kind of figuring out what I'm going to do here. Really, what I should have done is filled that spot up so those two spikes aren't lower than the other ones. So, As Russell Wilson would say, that's on me. Russell Wilson being, of course, the quarterback of the Seahawks. I'm pretty sure everybody that's watching knows that, sweetheart. You don't have to be from Washington to love Russell Wilson. Of course, if you didn't love him, he'd probably say, it's okay, that's on me.
Zing.
I experiment with some faster travel here. Basically, just hold the space bar down when you're going down. If you are sure you have the hay bale down there, just go ahead and just drop. You're going to be just fine. Also, I've been thinking more about the underground forge area we're going to do down here. Pretty excited. Definitely looking forward to it. It's just, at this point, it's just trying to find the time to play, finding the time to not forget to turn the mic on, because I spent time making the video, I spent time editing, and now I gotta spend, you know, another 25, 26 minutes, of time that I don't necessarily have to sit down and do this. You know, there's lots of other stuff I probably should be doing, and so just making sure that I have the time. Oh, yep, and I pull out some more scrap, and we wind up using that to, I believe, reinforce the spikes we made. But like I was saying, you know, I spend time playing, recording, and when I forget to turn the mic on, you know, I spend a little bit of time editing. It's not as much now that I've switched to Marillas from Fraps, because the file size is like a tenth the size, so it just goes faster, you know, just because of that. But then having to spend the time to turn around and continue, or to narrate this now, it all takes time. So. What happened? Oh, okay, weird. Just out of wood, apparently. I will wrap this up. And this always feels good to do. Get all these things upgraded. And then, of course, that's, you know, you can turn those spikes back into wood planks, which I didn't know until recently here, actually. Watching, who was I watching play? I think it was Rongo I was watching play. By the way, we're doing the S'more and Rongo multiplayer, so definitely make sure to check that out. I think I got a real fun episode. Let's see, I have dropped one on Monday, dropped one today, Wednesday, and then also got one lined up for Friday yet. Looks like I forgot to fill that particular cement piece. And I made a mistake somewhere, because it's not perfectly circular and I'm still trying to figure out where. And it's far too late now, and I don't realize, like right now as I'm playing, I haven't realized I've made the mistake. Which sucks. But, you know, that's how it is, and it's imperfect, so we're going to work with it. I wish they had some sort of gate or drawbridge mechanism, and maybe those bigger machines are coming in later alphas after they've got water and hopefully plumbing going, so we can build these much more bigger and complicated machines. Because it would be nice to be able to put a gate on what will become the inside face of the perimeter of the tower, so that way, you know, once I do get a big wall up, I can not either have to go up a ladder, worry about a metal door, because I'm not a big fan of doors to begin with, them being just a little bit of a weak point in your build. But if we had a gate or a drawbridge or something, we could use terrain to protect these structures and make them a little more redundant. Instead of, let's say, the wall got breached that I plan on building and I'm inside this big compound here, running to any of the, you know, towers I'm going to wind up building, similar to this one, only better and not, you know, slightly misshapen. I don't have to worry about a door on the inside. I have a drawbridge or a big fancy portcullis gate, or, you know, I feel like there are a lot of options, and I'm excited to see what they implement. Also, there's that weird graphical glitch going on. It almost looks like a lightning, and I'm not sure what it's from, but I think we'll see more of it, actually. And that was me just doing a quick 360 to see if there's horde or anything coming by. Because again, I've got the furnace going down there, just cranking away. We ran out of metal frames, and so we need some more metal. So that's what we're gonna do. Is we're gonna go and get some more metal, and you know, hopefully it will be enough to continue to keep going. I think I do wind up making several trips. Again, just hold down spacebar, and you'll just fly down the hole. And then land safely on the hay bale. Boy, if only I'd have thought to put multiple forges down here. That would have been good. It's too bad I didn't. Would have definitely saved some time. I think, though, another thing, too, is I didn't want to get a whole bunch of forges going down here. Just have to break them down and redo a big fancy design later. I know that was one of the things I was kind of thinking of, too. At the time, as well as trying to figure out just how exactly I'm going to do that whole thing. So, still on my mind, still working on, figuring it out. But there's several different aesthetic designs I want to incorporate with the forges. I want there to be 5 and have them all accessible while standing in the same spot. I want to have a fuel chest, so anything that I would burn to power the forges, I want those nearby. I want them to include some campfires. However I do this build, so that way I have campfire access right there too, and a number of campfires, grills, pots, beakers. Here I am trying to figure out exactly how much wood I think I'm gonna need and what I'm gonna use it for. It looks like, I forgot I did this. It looks like I actually take a break from building the tower in my infinite wisdom. And we work down here on the little wooden rampart, it looks like. I know the whole time I've been saying I'm so nervous about the 13 and 14 day hordes. Let me get that tower finished, but apparently I was not so nervous as to not continue working on this. Maybe I just needed some more room to maneuver around down here. It didn't take very long to get this up and running. Or maybe I wanted to show us a little bit more of kind of what I had in mind down here. That's probably it. But a series of wooden ramparts and platforms that all kind of work together. And I upgraded that one too much and it will drive me crazy. But with the forges, I want, like I was saying, I want 5 forges, all accessible from the same spot. Same thing with the campfires, 5 campfires, again, all accessible from the same spot. I want them to look more than just the one block entity. I want them to, I want them to look several, just much more than one block, I guess. I'm not quite sure how to say it better than that, really. But I remember building the huge automatic furnaces in Minecraft. There, we're gonna take care of that right there. But building these huge elaborate furnaces in Minecraft and this one little block thing is just not enough. It's just, oh, I know what I was doing. I was waiting for more iron to be forged. So, let's see, do I do anything else down here? Nope, looks like I take off running to go continue to build the tower. So let's see, 5 forges, all access from the same place, 5 campfires, same thing. I want them to be a little more than just a one block entity, so I have some ideas how I'm gonna do that. I wanna be able to tell what item is in which forge without having to open the forge. Not absolutely sure how I'm gonna do that, but I've got some ideas. And then stealing some designs from Double Tap, I think was the player's name, from one of Rongo's last base tours. Notice how I don't even think I closed the door there on my way out. I want to incorporate some of the piping or ducting. Like I want to fancy it up a little bit, because anybody can just throw a forge down and then and just go, as I did earlier in the last episode or this episode. I want to do more. I want to show other people some different builds, give other people ideas, and see what other people come up with, so maybe I can steal some of their ideas, if they're using mine. So, I mean, hell, I think Cage is going to wind up using my tower build from the hub city that Rongo showcased in one of his subscriber base tours. So I'm interested to see where that goes. Just passing the 20-minute mark here. And it's looking good. I love the line of sight. I like the gently rolling hill here, trying to think of different ways to use that. And as I'm watching me play here, I'm already seeing some different things I wish I had done around this tower, dirt leveling wise and such, that I know I'll use, you know, later on when building the other towers that I'd like to build. So, because every tower should, you know, I'd like to have to be able to hold up to you know, full size horde. So no matter where I'm at or what I'm doing, I'll have a safe place to run back to. Yep, just continuing to put layers on this thing. Not quite sure how high I'm going to take it. I know I want things to be able to die on the spikes. I don't want them to stand on the spike and then turn around and just beat up the next layer of block. You know, I don't want them to be able to take out the lip, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So just, you know, trying to keep all that in mind. How are your guys' 7 Days to Die worlds going? I hope they're going well. Hope you guys are having success. I see some of the guys that I'm sub to, they're up to video almost 40, I think. I think I saw Endem up to 39 episodes. You know, we're just now getting close to 30. Plus his Hub City base is awesome. It's very impressive and I like it a lot. I think there's only a very few things I would want to do differently, and that's not to say that his isn't awesome and working great for him. So I think here is when I finally get the bright idea to spell correctly. Yep. Good times. So here I finally realize, oh, I have a whole bunch of iron. Because there's a ton of iron down here, oh my gosh. And I went and got some off camera between the last episode and this episode, which is where all that ore came from. I can just, you know, make a few more forges and a few more iron molds and go to town. It's too bad it took this long for me to think that I could do that. So, a good lesson learned. And here just divvying up, you know, the material and fuel and such. So all right guys, well that about does it. I think we're gonna end this episode here. As always, thank you very much for watching. I promise in the future I have a sticky note set up for myself. I will keep the mic on, holy cow. Starting some new Witcher series here hopefully soon, so keep an eye open for that. Definitely going to get some more Wife and Hubs series going. And as always, I will talk with you guys later.